Hello students, in this video we will study about Hoffmann-Loeffler-Freytag reaction. What is it? It is actually the formation of pyrrolidine or piperidine by the thermal or photochemical decomposition of protonated and haloamines. So the initial compound for this reaction is what? It is n-haloamines. That is like this. This compound is called n-haloamines. Why? Because at this is amine, and at this nitrogen a chlorine is attached, so it will be called n-haloamines. Okay, now the first condition for this reaction is that there should be present a delta hydrogen atom. It means this is the alpha position, this is beta position, this is gamma position, and this is the delta position, and a hydrogen should be present at this position. Okay, so the reaction proceeds when this compound is firstly protonated, and then the reaction mixture is subjected to the heat. It means then the reaction mixture is heated, or it is subjected to the UV radiation. Okay, in the first step we will protonate this compound, and then we will heat the reaction mixture or exposes to the UV radiation, and in the next step it is treated with the base. So in the presence of the base, the compound is converted to the pyrrolidine or its derivative. It means we will get a product like this. This is called the pyrrolidine derivative. So the n-haloamines, as a result of the Hoffmann-Loeffler-Freytag reaction, are converted to the pyrrolidine or its derivative. Okay, now we see the mechanism of this reaction. What is the mechanism of this reaction? The first step is the protonation of the compound. This is the n-haloamine. So it is firstly protonated. So what happens? The proton will get attached at this nitrogen. So here will come a positive charge. Okay. Now when this compound is exposed to the UV radiation or it is heated, then what will happen? There will be a homolytic fission of this bond. It means, what is homolytic fission? Homolytic fission means one electron will go here and another electron will go with this chlorine. It means we are getting two different radicals. One radical is chlorine radical, and another radical is formed with this compound. As there is a positive charge also on this compound, so this we call a radical cation. This is a radical cation. Now what happens in the next step? In the next step, this will undergo the 1,5 hydrogen transfer. How it will be possible? This is the alpha position, this is beta position, this is gamma position, and this is delta position, and here is a hydrogen atom present, right? So we can also write this compound in this way. This can also be written like this. This is the nitrogen. This is our R group. This is R2. And here is R1. Okay. This is R1 and this is R2. Right. So here a hydrogen is present. And here is a positive charge. And this is one unpaired electron. Okay. This is R1 and this is hydrogen. We can also write it alpha, beta, gamma, and this is the delta position, right? Now what will happen? There will be a 15 hydrogen shift. It means this bond. We can write it like this. One electron will go here and one electron will go here. The one electron shift is shown by this fishhook arrow. Okay, so one electron will come here and one electron will go here. Okay, so between these two electrons a new bond is created. Okay, so we can write it like this. This is nitrogen and another one hydrogen bond is also formed here. So here comes two hydrogens, okay, and here this is R1 and here a new radical is formed in this way, and here is a positive charge, right? Now what happens in the next step? As we know, this is a reaction mixture and several molecules of N haloamines are present here. So this radical can abstract one chlorine radical from the another compound, another molecule. It means this provides a propagation step for this reaction. The compound that we get is another radical and that will also go this reaction. So this chlorine radical is abstracted from the another molecule here. This will go here, okay. So here a new bond is formed between this chlorine and this radical, all right. In this way. Now in the next step, what is the next step here? The next step is the presence of the base. When this reaction mixture is subjected to the base, a base is introduced in the reaction mixture, then what will happen? This base will abstract a hydrogen from here. This will attack on this bond. This bond will go here. Okay, so this proton is being abstracted, so here the negative charge will disappear. Okay, in the next step, what is the next step? The next step is the SN2 mechanism. This compound will undergo a second bimolecular substitution reaction, nucleophilic substitution reaction, that we call SN2 reaction mechanism. It means this will attack here and this chlorine will go outside as a leaving group. It means we are getting chloride ion as a leaving group. So here a bond is formed between this carbon atom and this nitrogen atom. So as a result of the SN2 reaction mechanism, bond is formed here. This is the nitrogen, this is the R2 group and this is the hydrogen, okay, and a positive charge comes here. Okay, in the next step what happens? Again in the presence of the base, this hydrogen is being abstracted, so this bond will go here. And we are getting Dopper product. It means the pyrrolidine derivative is formed as a result of this reaction. Okay, now we will see some more examples where the Hofmann-Loeffler Freytag reaction is used in the synthesis of the natural products. For example, if we see this example, there is a compound that is N haloamine. Here, when this is treated with the H2SO4 at 140 degree centigrade and then further it is treated with the NaOH, it means a base. Firstly, it is treated under the acidic condition and then with a base, then what happens? We can see here, this is a N-haloamine and this is alpha position, beta position, gamma position and delta position. At delta position, there are hydrogen atoms present. This is a CH3 group. So here, hydrogens are present. So this will undergo Hofmann-Loeffler-Freytag reaction. As a result, what will happen? There will be a reaction between this position and this position. It means a new bond is formed between the delta position and the nitrogen. So we can write alpha, beta, gamma, delta. Okay, this is the nitrogen. So a bond is formed between this position and this position and we get this product, right? Okay, now see the another molecule. When it is subjected to the same conditions, what will happen? Okay, in this condition you can see here, this is also a N-haloamine. And what is of the delta position? You can see here alpha, beta, gamma, and this is the delta position. So this is the position of which the hydrogens will interact with this position, right? So our product will be like this. We are not giving here the complete mechanism. Why? Because we have given already the mechanism. So you can watch that mechanism firstly and then do these questions. So here a new bond is formed between this position and this position. This is the nitrogen and this is the carbon of the delta position. And a new bond is formed. This bromine is the leaving group. So we will get this product, that is nicotine. So in this way, different products can be synthesized by using this reaction. Okay, let's see another situation. What happens when there are more than one delta positions present? Then which hydrogen will be abstracted and where we will get a new bond? For this, we have to see the two positions. It means which will give the more stable carbocation. For example, see this compound. Here in this compound, this is the nitrogen atom to which the chlorine is attached. This is alpha position, this is beta position, this is gamma and this is delta carbon atom, right? And here also alpha, beta, gamma and delta position. So there are two different delta positions present. Now which hydrogen will be used here? Here you can see this is the methyl group and the hydrogen attached to it will be primary. This is the primary stage and here this is the carbon atom to which hydrogen is attached and this is secondary position. So when this position will give the primary radical while this will give the secondary radical, and we know that the tertiary carbocation is more stable than secondary and it is more stable than primary than methyl radical, right? So the secondary radical is more stable, so the hydrogen will be abstracted from this position to give the more stable carbocation. So a new bond will be formed between this carbon atom and this nitrogen. Okay, so we can write here like this. This is the nitrogen and at which this methyl group we will attach here. And this group will be present as the side chain. Now you can see here 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 carbon atoms are present. So our side chain will be C4H9. So this will be our product. Okay, now see the next example. This is a natural product. And when it is treated with the H2SO4 and exposed to the UV radiation and then it is treated with the base, what will happen here? Okay. Now you can see here, this is the nitrogen to which chlorine is attached. This is alpha position, beta position, gamma position and this is the delta position. This is the suitable delta position. There are also another delta position but that is not suitable. This is the suitable position because it is in the direct, in this its stereochemistry is suitable for this nitrogen. So the hydrogen will be abstracted from this position, from this methyl group, right? So a bond will be formed between this carbon atom and the nitrogen atom. Okay, so our product will be, what will be our product? I am not writing here the full configuration. I am writing only this side. Why? Because whole the structure will remain as it is. So we does not need to write whole the structure. We can write it like this. Okay, and this is our methyl group. This is the carbon of that methyl group, right? And this is the methyl group attached to this carbon atom. This is the nitrogen and another methyl group attached to it, and a new bond is formed between this and this in this way, right? So this will be our product, and here is one hydrogen attached at this position, and the rest of the structure will remain as it is. So this will be our product. Okay, so this is all about the Hofmann-Loeffler-Freytag reaction. The reaction is quite simple and you can easily understand it, and you have to simply see which delta hydrogen atom is suitable for the reaction. If you can watch this, then you can easily find out which will be the major product, right? Okay, thank you.